Scary Smart by Mo Gawdat. 2022 was the year that I realized that we were going through a monumental shift. We were entering the era of AI. At the beginning of that year, I got my hands on a tool that could generate artworks in the style of any artist in seconds, and all it demanded of me was a single line of text. I was amazed, especially since I work as an artist in the games industry and I know how much work goes into generating images of that quality. The AI was competent but flawed. It created messed up faces and the hands were all weird and it couldn't interpret text. 6 months later, I decided to revisit the technology and my mind was blown again. All the flaws had been fixed. It could now create faces, hands, and the quality of the artwork was beyond most people's capabilities, except maybe for the real art masters. This type of accelerated learning is made possible through neural networks that are built through deep learning algorithms. This is what we today call AI. The revolution has begun and we're heading towards very weird times. Hi and welcome to the Book Lab. I'm Björn and this is the place where we bring you the best book recommendations when it comes to philosophy, psychology, human nature and human potential every week. So make sure to subscribe. Today we talk about Scary Smart by Mo Gawdat. Mo, he is a former chief business officer at Google X, and he's also famous for his book, The Solve for Happy. This book, Scary Smart, it's a call to action. Among the book's content, we find a short history of AI development and also a great chapter, my favorite chapter in the whole book, about how AI learns. It's super fascinating. It contains predictions of how the near future will play out, both the joys and the horrors. It also talks about how we can make the infancy of AI as frictionless as possible, avoiding unnecessary trauma, and create the best possible environment for AI to develop as a technology. We are at the crossroads now where it's not yet too late to decide what direction to take AI in. AI is in its infancy, but it's growing up really fast. And metaphorically, we are the parents to this super child. It learns from us, it takes instructions from us, and we indicate through our actions what it means to live a successful life. This is all fine and good as long as we are good and caring and loving parents, but if you ever seen a superhero movie, you know that there's also supervillains that are driven by greed, vengeance, and selfish desires. Mo Gawdat argues that the guidance and the values that we pass on to the AI is gonna determine if the future that we are heading towards will be a dystopia or a utopia. It won't be easy. Bad things will most definitely happen, but AI doesn't have to be the end of humanity. The three inevitables. One, AI will happen. Two, it will become smarter than us. Three, bad things will happen. At least in the short term, mistakes and errors will be made. Quote, when you and I have an accident driving a car, you and I learn. When a self-driving car makes a mistake, all self-driving cars learn. When you work with exponential technology and you are at 1%, then you are almost done. A doubling of 1% is only 7 doublings away from 100%, and a great example of this is the Human Genome Project, which was predicted to take about 15 years. And after 7 years, they were only 1% complete. People started to look at the project with a more skeptical tone, but 7 years later, they were done. The minute we figure out quantum computing and are able to write software for it, that exact minute, AI will eclipse human intelligence. Quote, this is not a figure of speech here. I mean the exact minute. Quantum computing might be powered by double exponentials. compared to regular computers that follow Moore's law, which becomes about 16 times faster in 5 years, quantum computers might be 16,000-fold more powerful within the same time frame. The singularity. Singularity is a word that describes what happens when computers become smarter than us as humans, and we can no longer imagine what the future might have in store for us. We have had singularities before. Jason Shiva is quoted in this book talking about the invention of the spoken word. When humans spoke for the first time, that spoken word was a technology beyond which the horizon of how far we could go was unfathomable to the primitive creatures that preceded it. The oral tradition, religion, politics, education, media, entertainment, these are just a few examples of technology that sprang from the spoken word. Quote, "We make the tool, then the tool makes us." The difference with more recent technology, such as AI, is the baffling speed in which change happens. For the last 10 years, I've been reading at least one book each year about AI and automation, not only because it's a fascinating topic and I'm very interested in it, but also because I had a hunch that this technology will have a huge impact on the way we live our lives, and probably sooner than people expect. I have felt for the longest time that the political and the public debate has ignored the question of AI. We had an election here in Sweden last year, and I couldn't find anything about AI and automation on any of the party's agenda. I guess it's much easier to engage voters and get them to the poll station by talking about the environment or the situations with immigrants. But I feel it might have been a mistake not to talk about this sooner. The insane developments that we've seen the past 6 months, especially with ChatGPT, which is a chatbot that can help you with almost anything if you want to write a book review, or you want to write an essay, or if you want to write code, it can do so much, and it's just amazing that we're already at this point. And ChatGPT might have been the wake-up call that we all needed. Scary Smart is probably the best introduction to AI for people who don't have a tech background. It's super accessible and it paints a shocking yet grounded picture of the future that we are facing and the challenges that AI poses to humanity as a whole. Even though the book loses a bit of steam towards the end, I think this is a great choice if you want to read up on the topic of AI. I listen to this book as an audiobook, and if you're not using audiobooks already, check out my videos on how to get started with audiobooks. It's a great complement to reading physical books because you can do it on the go and so on. The narrator has a bit of an accent, so make sure to sample it before you buy so that you know you can stand the voice. If you're not up to date with AI development, waste no time, get this book, read up on it, because there's a lot of things going on, and I think 2023 is going to be absolutely crazy. Make sure to subscribe to this channel so that you can get book recommendations every day. I have a few new books that I want to talk about that I have reviews coming up for. It's been long in the making, but Søren Kierkegaard, my first Søren Kierkegaard, Fear and Trembling, I have a review up on that very soon. And I'm also reading Goethe's The Sorrows of Young Werther. Why? Well, I really liked Faust, which I reviewed on this channel before. And a friend of me, he just reread this book and said that I should try it out. We talked about it in elementary school or something like that, so it's gonna be nice to see what it's about. And I almost forgot, I have reviews coming up for Gabor Mate's When the Body Says No, which was a fantastic read. I also read Tuesdays with Mori, which is a book written by a journalist who is meeting an old professor who is dying from ALS, and he shares some really cool life lessons, so I'm gonna have a review up on that. And also, I've looked into a book that I read when I was 15 years old, The Art of Happiness by Dalai Lama. Very interesting to revisit that 15 years later, or 20 years later. Who am I kidding? I'm getting old. Let me know in the comments about your thoughts about artificial intelligence, where we're heading, what's your concerns, what's your hopes. And I'll be back next week with more book reviews. And until then, Björn out.